Now to our university campuses, which have over the last decade or so become intellectual wastelands run by the progressive, or they call themselves progressive left. And of course, this has extended to the debate over the race-based referendum. Joining me to get the latest on this is Garrick, Professor of Law at University of Queensland, James Allan. James, welcome to the program. The taxpayer-funded University of New South Wales lit up one of its main buildings with a big yes sign. Is this the sort of activism that's become the norm across Australia's universities?
Well, thank you for having me on, Rita. I think it really is the norm. There have been quite a few universities come out explicitly for yes. This is despite this not just being a contentious referendum, it's a party political one where one party is on one side and one on the other. Mm-hmm. And these universities are taking your tax monies and all of them citing yes. Now, there are some universities that have come out neutral. But what that means at the granular level is when they put on these information sessions, virtually everyone who's supposed to speak to the students or the other staff are yes supporters. And it's actually quite incredible.
Yeah. Well, tell me about this group think, because yes, there are these information sessions, but you're not getting equal time to the no campaigners. Are there any no campaigners on campus? Is there any visible signs of those activists, or are they too scared to show their face?
Well, it's, you know, there's loads of social science evidence in the US and the UK that viewpoint diversity is collapsing on universities. I think it's the same in Australia. It's not a very congenial place on campus for conservatives. I'm an out-of-the-closet conservative. And by the way, if Dennis wants to have a bet on the referendum, I'm willing to bet a nice bottle of wine that it loses badly. But so I'm out of the closet.
Ooh.
But I think, you know, if you want to work in a place where there's 27 flags and you have to wear purple, and you're basically, you have a sort of indoctrination run down your throat. A lot of people don't like that. And if you're junior and you're going for promotions, or you're a student and you're worried about what mark you're going to get, you just don't say anything. Mm. And they are not, you know, they're not supposed to be monolithic orthodoxies. And that is the problem. It's a big problem.
Well, absolutely. I mean, you are supposed to have intellectual curiosity. You're supposed to have debates and viewpoint diversity at university, but you've got instead this groupthink and this climate of censorship, including self-censorship. Do you find that with students? They are as worried about saying what they really think as the academic staff, because there's just no real tolerance, even for mainstream views that deviate from leftist orthodoxy.
Well, if you wanted just a soupçon of optimism, I think it's so overdone that you get quite a few students who just become cynical, and their view is, well, just say what I think I need to say to get my good mark, and I don't, you know, they just become totally cynical about the whole thing. Now, that's not great, but it's better than, you know, having factories of indoctrination. So I think there is a level of cynicism, and I think a lot of students do realize that this is what I have to say. And again, it's not just done directly, it's done indirectly. So again, if you're a faculty member, you're thinking about your promotion, it's done indirectly through grants. If you're not in the hard sciences and you're a social science, you would never get a grant to say, to be in favor of stopping the boats, say, or pick your favorite contested issue that the right of center position, the ARC just ignores. And then you go for promotion and they don't say you're a conservative. They say, hey, you didn't get any grants. So,
well, yeah, it's quite a trick they've pulled.
I mean,
the left's marched through the institutions. They started with the universities. They're everywhere now. They're in the corporate world as well, but they are very, very effective indeed. And professors like you are a marvel, because it takes great bravery to take a stand. Professor Allan, thank you so much for your time tonight.